Biden says that he's doing this to reduce the number of people being killed by these types of weapons. And by these types of weapons, he means AR-15s, AK-47s. So according to the FBI, the Uniform Crime Report, which is a report that's published every single year, that talks about the number of people that were murdered, the types of races, which race killed which race, what weapons were used, and things like that.
Yep.
So in 2019, there were 13,927 people murdered in the United States.
Okay.
So 13,927. That's a lot.
Yeah.
It's not that much.
Yeah,
okay? Not that much. Out of the people killed with a rifle, were 364 people were killed with a rifle. So that means 2.6% of people that were murdered were actually killed with a rifle.
Right. 2.6%. So why are we going after rifles? I mean,
45% of people that were murdered were killed with a handgun.
Right. So they should be going after handguns, technically.
But that's,
if you were really concerned about stopping, you know.
But that also goes to show when I play this video of this Jewish woman that survived World War II.
When are you going to play it?
Okay, let's just talk about it right now.
Yeah, because everybody wants to see this.
It's really amazing. So this is the woman here. So again, she grew up as a child, survived World War II.
Yeah.
And here's a video. It's about a minute or so long.
Okay.
We also had gun control. The government said that children were playing with guns, and we had hunting accidents, people accidentally shooting each other, and we had criminals again, murderers. The only way that they could track the murderer was by the serial number of the gun. So bring your gun to the police station, then we can register the serial number, and we can track the criminal. And we thought that was a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
So gladly we did that. Not long afterwards, they said, no, it did not help. We could not track all the criminals. The best way to have no more crimes and no more people getting hurt, bring your guns to the police station. And they already know who had guns because we registered our guns. Keep your guns and buy more guns. And and stack up on your ammo. A gun is no good if you don't have any ammo. Dictatorship did not happen overnight. It took 5 years. From 1938 until 1943, we had a full-blown dictatorship. Had we kept our guns, we would have fought a bloody battle to the last man and woman to keep our freedom. But we had no guns. A classic example is, in Switzerland, it is law that everybody has to have a gun.
Okay, so it's really, really interesting what that lady had to say. And again, that's just a 2 minute clip of a 40 minute video that I will post with some commentary.
And everybody needs to watch it. And you know what? I really strongly urge you, if you have children, no matter how old they are, our kids are, you know, 6, 9, and 11, and they love watching stuff like that because they're the next generation that's going to fight for our gun rights, right?
Yeah. What's interesting is she talks about how Hitler took over the media, controlled what people were allowed to hear,
controlled what was taught in schools,
took away freedom of religion, took away freedom of speech. Mm-hmm. Does that sound familiar to what's happening right now?
Right. So she talked about Switzerland.
Yeah.
And what did I say this morning? Before I even seen this, I said, you know, Ryan, I'm really worried. And he said, why? And I said, because if they take away our AR-15s, I said, what is going to stop China, Russia?
Well, that's a good point.
All these countries that have been, North Korea, that have been waiting, that we're the superpower. Everybody wants to be in America's shoes. And I said, what's going to happen? Because was it the Korean guy or the who was it?
It was a Japanese general.
It was a Japanese general that they said, why didn't you go to America and attack? And he said,
No. Why, after Pearl Harbor, why did you not do a ground invasion?
Okay. And he said, because there is a rifle behind every blade of grass. And that is the same reason why Hitler did not try to attack Switzerland, because he knew there was a rifle behind every blade of grass.
So here's the way it works in Switzerland. So every single male is in the military their entire life. Mm-hmm. So you serve a certain period in active duty. So it's probably like 2 to 6 years.
Yeah.
Which I think should be the law in America. I think we'd have less pussification if that happened.
Yeah, I think that there would be a lot more patriotism as well.
Yeah. So you have to go into the military, and then for the rest of your life, you're kind of like in inactive status. So I did 6 years active duty, and then I had to do 2 years of inactive status.
Right.
So if something bad happened, they need me to come back, law have to go back and serve
but
again.
But you would go back. And in a second.
So in Switzerland, after you go into that inactive status, they give you a machine gun. They give you crates of ammunition.
Yep.
And they say it is your responsibility, along with your neighbors, to defend your area, your community, from all enemies, foreign and domestic.